Pleasant morning to everyone.
Morning.
Such a blessing for us to be here this morning.
Amen.
And we thank God for the message and song. Because He lives. If He did not rise again, our hope would be in vain. So why seek ye the living among the dead? Amen.
Amen.
We serve a risen Savior.
Amen.
And He is in the world today. And it's about time that men ought to rejoice.
Amen.
That our God is alive. Amen.
Amen.
I want to remind us that God formed us. Sin deformed us. Education informs us. But the blood of Jesus transforms us. Amen. Someone once said, when he was asked, what does a person need in order of peace, happiness, and contentment in life? His answer was, someone to love, something to do, and something to look forward to. What a beautiful answer, amen. And for those of you who love titles, I've entitled the message, The Urgency of the Emergency. I invite you to bow your heads with me as we have a word of prayer. Loving Heavenly Father, it is your grateful hearts we come before your throne of grace once more to give you thanks for being so good to us. As we meet in this beautiful setting, we ask, O Lord, that you will embrace us with your presence, not just amongst the pews, but may your Holy Spirit be with us and in us. And as you open your words, open our minds and give us understanding, may we learn something that will draw us closer to you. And we will be careful to give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. These mercies we do ask in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Amen. Whether you like it or not, we are indeed all brothers and sisters. What do you say?
Amen.
And even the five great races of the world, all related by blood.
Amen.
And then the 17th chapter, the 26th verse of the book of Acts, we are all related by blood, and he had made of one blood all the nations of men. And blood is mentioned in the Bible over 700 times. And sometimes it may be that we don't get all that God intends for us. And then Leviticus chapter 17 and verse 11, it says, Leviticus 17 and verse 11, for the life of the flesh is in the blood. And I have given it to you to make an atonement. For it is the blood that makes an atonement for the soul. The first part of the verse says, for the life of all flesh. For the blood of it is for the life thereof. Blood is mentioned in the Bible throughout. It passes through the body about 4 or 5 pints of it every 3 minutes. And thousands of times a day, our heart beats to get a nourishment which nourishes and brings strength as well as cleansing to the body. Blood is vital. And in Matthew chapter 1, it talks about the birth of Jesus. And it says that so-and-so begat so-and-so, and it only mentions the man. The women are rarely mentioned. But in the case of Jesus, it says that he was born of a woman.
Yeah.
Only two individuals have been fathered by God. And that was Adam, and that was Christ. Because the angel said unto Mary, the thing which is conceived indeed is of the Holy Spirit. Amen? So by this we recognize that his birth was different. If I try to explain it, I'm going to lose my mind. But if you don't believe it, you can lose your soul. We need to recognize that this was a totally different situation, and that the blood of Jesus was somehow different and very significant. You might say that the human race, we all suffered from blood poisoning. We have all been born bad. Something is wrong with us. Amen. And in Hebrews chapter 2 and verse 14 it says, our scripture reading, "For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same, that through death he might destroy him that had the power of death, that is the devil." The birth of Jesus was different. Even his death was different. And even his resurrection, amen?
Mm-hmm.
I think that this is one of the greatest verses of scripture in the Bible. By the death of Jesus, he destroyed him that had the power of death. That is the devil. Now, death is the enemy of life. Death is the cessation of life. Death is not an act of God. When we depart from God's principles, the inevitable result is death.
Yes.
Sin, when it is conceived, brings forth death. Mm-hmm. Romans 3:23 says that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is death. The byproduct of living a sinful life, of being born bad, the end result is death. But you see, the word "but" is a conjunctive injunction. The word "but" changes that which have gone before from that which is to come. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God,
amen,
is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Salvation, my friend, is the gift that comes from God.
Amen.
We cannot work for it. We don't merit it. We cannot earn it. It's God's gift to us. Amen.
Amen.
And when Jesus was on the cross, in the very shameful condition that he was in, the Bible says that by his death he destroyed him that had the power of death, that is the devil. Amen?
Amen.
As in the case of David and Goliath, the moment that David cut off the head of Goliath with his own sword, all Israel began to rejoice. And you and I need to rejoice. Amen? Trouble does not last always. Joy comes in the morning, amen?
Amen.
It's only for a time. Because someone to love, something to do, and something to look forward to. We have a hope.
Yes.
The blessed hope, amen?
Amen.
And no one can live without hope. A person without hope is suicidal. Mm-hmm. But we have a hope because he came to give us life, the abundant life. We can look forward for something, amen?
Yes.
And all Israel began to rejoice, and I believe that it's time for you and I to rejoice, amen?
Mm-hmm.
A Christian is not a sad person. A Christian is a happy person. A Christian may experience sadness, but a Christian is a happy person, amen?
Amen.
Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. But notice the way that this is phrased. For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, the human race, we are born destitute and apart from God. We are born separated from holiness. The scripture says that when Nicodemus in John chapter 3 came to Jesus by night, Jesus said to Nicodemus, "You must be born again." And he said, "How can this be?" And Jesus said, "You are a teacher in Israel, and you don't know these things? All of us must be born again. Eternal gems of truth are sometimes spoken to one individual. So never underestimate a congregation of one." Amen?
Okay.
One with the Lord is the majority.
Amen.
It says that they are partakers. We are partakers of flesh and blood. The Greek word there is koinonia, which means to share completely and totally off. So we get what we get completely. We are partakers of koinonia. It means to share completely and totally. But a in the case of Jesus, it says that he likewise took part of the sin. So that means his blood was different. He had a sinful mother, but the Holy Ghost was his father. Amen?
Yes.
We are partakers of flesh and blood. But Jesus, and likewise, took part of the sin. The word there is metiko. The Greek word there for part of is metiko. He took part of, but not all of. So there is something special about the blood of Jesus. What do you say? Amen?
Amen.
The blood of the child is not determined by the father. The blood of the child is not determined by the mother.
Right.
The blood of the child is determined by the father. Amen?
Amen.
Now you didn't correct me.
I'm waiting.
Gotta have both.
I just did that to see if you were paying attention.
You have to have both.
The blood is determined by the father. See, Jesus had on this earth only a stepfather. He had as his father the Holy Spirit. His blood was different from us. The blood of the mother does not even pass through. Not even one drop of the mother passes through the fetal sac to the child. And I am told in Louis Nabrowski's nursing handbook that nurses used to study that not even one drop of the mother passes to the child. And we can notice this in the blood of other animals and even in the blood of chickens. The hen can sit on an egg for all eternity, it will never hatch. But soon as the rooster sits on the egg and fertilizes the egg, then you can pretty soon look through the egg on a light and see the blood even forming inside of the egg. So even the blood of other animals must be by the father. And so there is something special, something unique, something distinct about Jesus being born into the human race. The mother nurses and nourishes and cares for the baby. The baby eats and sleeps and breathes, but the blood is determined by the father. Blood is something special. So special that it is mentioned over 700 times in the scriptures for cleansing, and we can learn something about the blood of Jesus and even our natural side. There are approximately one-fifth of the body's weight, 5 quarts of blood in the human body that flows through the air. There are 3 types of cells. I'm not in the medical field, so I don't know all that there is to know. Amen. The red blood cells we call erythrocytes, the white blood cells we call leukocytes, and the platelets. Not much was known about the platelets, but maybe we know a little more today because of modern science. But in the red blood cells, there are about 5 million per cubic centimeter of the red blood cells that passes through the body as the heart beats and brings nourishment and oxygen and at the same time cleansing to the system. It is a transfer into the smaller capillaries of the body, of the blood. And the red blood cells are bringing oxygen and nourishment and brings our temperature, our metabolism. It is a transfer of, it keeps your temperature at approximately 98.6 or so degrees. I did my blood test a couple of weeks ago, some lab work, and I went back this week for the results. The doctor looked at it and said, everything is fine. All I need is some B12, because all vegetarians need B12, amen? So I started using some B12 this week. But he said, it's okay. And that makes you feel good, because the blood is the life of the soul, amen? The life of the flesh is in the blood. And as this operation goes on, if infection has invaded the body, is introduced into the body, the temperature begins to be elevated, and the white blood cells begin to multiply. If it goes out of control, we call that leukemia, amen? But there is power. in the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Whenever we are infected or we are bombarded with sin, we have the red blood cells of Jesus that has the power already built into it. So we can live an overcoming life. Amen. The blood of Jesus, as well as the, you might say, it represents the grocery man that brings nourishment to the body, and the garbage man that takes away the trash out of the exhaust system. Amen.
Amen.
So that as this operation goes on to the various organs of the body, there's cleansing and there's power to be found in the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And we can say, the thing I used to do, I do that no more, because there is not an inner goodness in us. There is not a power within us to do any good thing. It's an outside power that is because of the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
I remember many years ago I was told that Mrs. Reagan was even praising God on national television for the successful surgery she had on cancer. Aren't you thankful that the blood of Jesus reaches from the White House to the poor house? It reaches from the front of the church even to the back of the church. It reaches behind prison bars. Amen.
Amen.
The blood of Jesus has power in it.
Amen.
That will never lose its power. The white blood cells, about 4,000 to 7,000 per cubic centimeter, is called a standing army. And when infection invades the body or we are bruised, and the standing army begins to multiply and forms a pus and a scalp. It's not pretty, but it's necessary. Amen. Sometimes not everything that calls for healing in our body is not pretty, but it is necessary. And there are many people today who are hurting, not so much physically perhaps, from some tragic accident, but we are hurting because of the way the world treats us. We are hurting because of the way other people treat us, and sometimes we are hurting because of the way we treat ourselves. But I have good news for us. Even though the devil is after us, and all that goes on in the Christian warfare, we are being buffeted by the winds of strife. The good news is that the blood of Jesus Christ not only brings cleansing, but it has in it the propensities that will help you to heal the wounds of life. There is rush to the place of infection, the white blood cells of the blood of Jesus. And you can read about it in the book of Revelation chapter 12 and verse 11. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, and by the word of the testimony, and they loved not their lives even unto the death. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. There is overcoming power in the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus has in it something that will help us to heal over the wounds of the spiritual warfare in life. And when you feel that you haven't really made it, and you aren't going to make it, and you don't feel worthwhile, that you are worth something, that you don't feel important, that you are special, that you are unique, that you are valuable in the sight of God, you always have the blood of Jesus. Amen. And I believe that the Christian church sometimes is the only army that tends to shoot the wounded. It should have a fresh supply of the blood of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
When people are hurting, they need to feel welcome, they need to feel appreciated, they need to feel loved. Sometimes all that people need is to know that somebody is, does somebody care for me? Amen?
Amen.
That makes you feel wanted. That makes you feel important, that you're special. And they need to be reminded that they have royal blood running through their veins.
Amen.
That they are special, that they are children of the King. Another thing is that, I remember when I was getting my inoculation at a very early age, just as basically a child. All of us have gotten different shots because they haven't, I'm not talking about the corona shot. Amen. This one is totally different. The only thing that can protect us from the corona is the blood of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
So when you have a place that when we are inoculated, it begins to form a pus and it got sometimes infected. But Jesus said, he's about to leave. But he says, when I go, I will pray the Father and give you another comforter. Amen. Which is the Holy Spirit. So we are not alone. Jesus is always with us in the person of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Because he has promised, I will never leave you, nor forsake you. Another thing is blood type. Remember weeks or months ago, I asked the church to pray for me because my brother had a rare blood type. And he had to have, a transfusion. And I had to be tested to see if I was the correct match. So I got the test, and I came back an exact match, and I began to rejoice, and I began to feel good, and he was so happy so that he can live a normal life. What they were going to do, they were going to inject into my bloodstream something that will cause my white blood cells to multiply. And then they would extract the white blood cells and they would save it, and then they would put back the blood into my body. I didn't understand everything about the procedure, but if there was something that I could do that will save his life, I was willing to do it. But during the meantime, he got an infection because he was ever so weak. And he never came out of the infection. He went in, he walked in, he was in his right mind. There are some things I cannot understand by these physicians. They put you to sleep. They sedate you to the point where you can barely open your eyes. And he was in that condition for over 1 month. And he never woke up. The same thing happened to my brother-in-law up in New York. He walked into the hospital. He had some problems. He walked in his right mind. They sedated him, and he never opened his eyes for over a month. Never woke up. But I thank God, when Jesus comes to us, anybody he heals, they are conscious. They're in the right mind, amen?
Amen.
He didn't put it to sleep. He came that we might have life and that we might have it more abundantly. I thank God for the blood of Jesus, amen?
Amen.
I think about a thief on the cross. Jesus' blood was the right type for him.
Amen.
My blood type might have been the right type for my brother. But the blood of Jesus is the right type for every individual upon the face of this earth. Amen.
Hallelujah.
His blood type was the right type for Mary Magdalene, who lived a questionable life. She was called Mary of Magdala, or Mary Magdalene, because she went to live in Magdala. Whenever she ran out of money, you don't have to be too imaginative or too descriptive to know what she did for a living. Whom Jesus cast out 7 devils, not all at the same time. But when he was finally done, she was all right.
Amen.
Because of the blood of Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah.
I think about a demoniac. Deep in his heart of hearts and soul of souls, he wanted to live right, but he could not help himself. Because of the way he was being treated, and others treat him, and he treated himself. I imagine when he went home and he knocked on the door, his wife was scared and the children ran and had even the pets run away. But when Jesus was through with him, he was clothed and in his right mind.
Amen.
I think about Hebrews chapter 11, about Rahab the harlot. You don't have to imagine what she did for a living. And I don't know if the spies knew how the city was going to be taken. But they said to her, when we come marching into town, if you have that scarlet cord around your window, that represent the blood of Jesus. All who is found in this house will be saved.
Amen.
As soon as she let them down on a basket and they went on their way, the first thing she did, she made sure that that cord was around her window. And then she went and she invited her mother, her brother, her sister, and all that was willing to come into her house.
Amen.
I'm saying to us, friend of mine, you need to apply the blood of Jesus in your life first.
Amen.
Then tell others, make sure that your salvation is secure. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus saves us as individuals. Good families will be saved as individuals. Amen. All men can be saved as individuals, amen?
Yes.
And when they came into town, they knew that their leader was a good man, that they can trust him, amen? Her life was spared. She said, I don't want to fall when you come into town, amen? So she had the blood of Jesus. And she did not keep on living the way she did. Amazing enough. She got married to Salmon. Salmon begat Boaz. Boaz begat Obed. Obed begat Jesse. Jesse begat David. David begat Solomon. And you go down through the list. And you get all the way down to Joseph, who begat to Jacob, who begat Joseph, of whom Jesus was born. It did not say that Joseph begat Jesus. Joseph was only a stepfather. Amen. He had nothing to do with the birth of Jesus. He had on his earth the Holy Spirit as his father. Amen. The blood of Jesus is the right time for you and me. What do you say? He brings cleansing. With the blood of Jesus, he saves us. He strengthens us day by day. And keeps us safe in the world of sin. And he can make us a saint. Amen. All of us are saints here this morning. Amen.
Hallelujah.
A saint is a living human being. There's no such thing like a dead saint. Amen. So you cannot be deified after you die. David said that the blood is incorruptible. Peter said that the blood is precious. John said the blood is overcoming. Even Judas said that the blood is innocent. There is a fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins. The sinner's blood beneath that flood lose all. Not some, lose all their guilty stains. God does not furnish a cloak for sin. He takes the sin away.
Amen.
Amen. Then again, the blood will never lose its power.
Yes.
It will never lose its power. And then Jesus preached one last sermon and he said, unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have no part. I have no part with you. He was not talking about cannibalism. Unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have no part with me. He preached a sermon to the 70, and many of his followers left him. And he said to the 12, are you going to leave also? And Peter said, where can we go? There is nowhere else to go, amen.
Yeah,
you have the words of eternal life.
Yes.
And he said, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit. And they are alive.
Amen.
He was not talking about his literal blood. John chapter 1. John said, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him. Without him was not anything made. And he got all the way down to verse 14, and the Word became flesh.
Amen.
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 And dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory.
Amen.
The glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. The blood of Jesus has power in it, friend of mine.
Yes.
God loves every single one of us. I turn your attention In case you're wondering where I got the title from, to the book of Exodus, chapter 12 and verse 11. The last plague in Egypt, the ninth plague, was darkness. Before Jesus died on the cross, darkness